Hello there, my name is Will Benson, and surrounding me you will see 10 aeroponic towers, which for the last 3 months I've been supplying my restaurant and my retail outlet with the most incredibly fresh, sustainable, no carbon mile foods, and have been an incredible backdrop for my customers. It's a really simple way to grow, no difficult computers, no heavy tech, just really simple, sustainable agriculture. On one tower, I've got these lovely heritage tomatoes. Down here, I've got some round cucumbers, and at the top, we've got some lovely lettuce. I've got pak choi, I've got chillies. You can see here, I've got some French beans in the background. And that is as much the beauty of this system. It allows you to grow a whole raft of different produce all on the same tower, meaning that you can change and develop what you're growing depending upon what the business needs. So here are the towers, looking amazing. And this is where we're using the towers. This is our outside garden area. And this is our barbecue. And we are harvesting directly every day. Some courgettes there. All of it coming off the towers. Goes incredibly well. Customers absolutely love seeing it. Chefs love going down and taking it off a fresh plant. It's literally win-win on every situation. So I hope that's some inspiration for people that might be thinking of growing this way. So the tower's incredibly easy to use. The system works by at the base of each tower, there is a container of water. There is a pump, and it simply pumps it to the very top of the tower, which then trickles down over the root ball of each of the plants, providing it with optimum liquid nutrient and oxygen. Each of the towers is provided liquid nutrient by a system in the background, which is very, very simple to use. This dosatron system will pull liquid nutrient out of each of these containers, stock solution A and B. It mixes it in the dosatron, and then that then provides this unit here with a perfectly mixed level of liquid nutrient. Then it's literally just down to gravity. Each of the towers has a ball cock. The ball cock, as the towers need more liquid nutrient, the ball cock will then simply ask for liquid nutrient, and down the pipe it goes, and then to the units through a little white pipe. It could not be simpler than that. So this is our production unit for seedlings, or at least one of them anyway. It's a very simple system. It's called a flood and drain, and it basically automates the feeding and the watering of the seedlings. It starts off with a unit down at the bottom with the liquid nutrient in it. It pumps it to the very top up here, which then goes across and then down, and then down again, floods into this tray and then back into the container. As you can see, we've got some very lovely produce growing. Coriander, we've got radish, we've got basil, we've got some oak leaf lettuce there, I believe. Some other lettuce type in the background. We've taken some heritage heirloom tomato cuttings there. We've got some micro herbs for the chefs. A whole load of stuff. Once they get big enough, they then move across into these, which are automated aeroponic propagators. They fire liquid nutrient up at the root ball, which you can just about see there. And that again automates the process of doing it. So we come in here maybe once every couple of days. It really takes care of itself. Right, so we're in the middle of January. It's -2 outside. Horticulture pretty much ends until you come into this cabin. And in this cabin, we brought all the towers that you saw outdoors indoors. We put them under full spectrum LED lights, which are actually pretty energy efficient. And we're growing a whole range of stuff. So we've got this beautiful purple pak choi chiso. We've got this frisée lettuce, red fire lettuce. We've got some rainbow chard. We've got tomatoes going on in the background, the Wonder Towers here. We're trialing borage, a beautiful borage plant there with the edible flowers. We've got a whole range of produce that is coming on. It's as much about trialing it for us at the moment in the idea that we're going to be building a very big greenhouse to do this. But at the same time, I'm also supplying our restaurant, our retail, and other people around the area. So it's doing really well on that level. And now I'm going to show you exactly how we produce the seedlings to go in here and also to distribute across the country. So this is a polymer-bound organic soil plug that you basically put the seedling into. I've got a special mix that allows for massive root growth in these seedlings, which then helps with putting them in the towers, the roots already established. But so these are seedlings to go in to the tower. There's a couple of orders for people to go out that have ordered from us for distribution. And then up here, these are some micro herbs that we're doing. Might be able to bring one of these down, although I only did them yesterday, so they won't be established yet. But this is a shiso micro herb with little seedlings coming up. You can just about see a few tap roots coming through. And we are then using that within our new wood-fired pizza system in the restaurant. So each of the pizzas comes with a little pot of micro herbs, sits within the actual packet or box of pizza, and when the client takes it home and they spread the micros on the top, works perfectly well. From an environmental perspective, these things are amazing. They only use 5% water that normal agriculture does. They grow 30% faster and 50% larger. Producing the seedlings in the background in a hydroponic fashion is really very easy. You simply then bring them out here, pop them into the system, and frankly, walk away. That's pretty much all that's needed. We've been utilizing them all summer for our restaurant. My chefs are coming out every day, three times a day, to then come and either take some lettuces for the burgers, micro herbs for the other dishes. It's been a revelation, frankly.